أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم In the name of Allah, the most beneficent, the most gracious, the most merciful This is Engineer Faisal Ijaz and today I am presenting a lecture on the manufacturing process of nitric acid by Osterwald method Also, I want to introduce my YouTube channel of Entitled Chemical Engineering EdTech I also have discussed different topics related to chemical engineering and title of these topics you are watching at background pages and if you people will subscribe my channel then you will get my latest videos today I am presenting a lecture on nitric acid industrial manufacturing process and to manufacture nitric acid a special type of method is used of name Osterwald method I will explain nitric acid industry with the help of raw materials, with the help of chemical reactions, and with the help of manufacturing steps, and also process flow diagram is provided. To manufacture nitric acid, three types of raw materials are used, in which the first one is anhydrous ammonia, and the second one is air, and the third one is water. Also here catalysts are used in which 90% platinum and 10% rhodium mixture of catalyst will be used according to chemical reactions in which reactants are reacting in three stages and in the first stage we get nitric oxide which convert itself into nitrogen dioxide by reacting again with air and in the third step we get our product which is nitric acid. Manufacturing of nitric acid take place through seven stages and the first one is filtration and compression of air, the second one is evaporation of ammonia, the third one is ammonia air mixing and the fourth one is oxidation of ammonia air mixture and the fifth one is cooling of gases and the sixth one is absorption of nitrogen peroxide in water in the presence of oxygen and the last is bleaching and storage of nitric acid. Now we are starting process description of process nitric acid and according to first step we will filter and compress air so in this section air is passing through filters and after that we will compress it so the purpose of filtration is to separate dust particles from air and after compression the temperature of air will increase till 300 centigrade and pressure will increase till 5 kg per meter square and now we will separate air into two parts and the first part will be cooled till 2 to 5 centigrade and will be used as a primary air and after that mixed with ammonia and the second part of that cool air we will cool it till 100 centigrade and after that we will use it as a secondary air to bleaching section. After converting liquid ammonia into vapors, now it is ready to mix with air, so send to the next section which is ammonia air mixture and in this section ammonia at 70 centigrade and air at 2 to 5 centigrade mix together with the ratio 1:9 so a mixture is prepared so during this all process temperature increase till 200 centigrade and that mixture is sent to the next section which is ammonia converter and in this converter again ammonia gas and air react with each other but in presence of catalyst so after that reaction we get again nitric oxide in this section temperature must be in controlled condition otherwise conversion of efficiency will be low and catalyst will be waste and after that gases cool and sent to absorption section cooling of gases, and these gases we obtained from previous section, which was ammonia converter, and these two gases were nitric oxide and nitrogen dioxide, and now we will decrease their temperature from 900 centigrade till 60 centigrade, and we will use different methods to cool them. And the first method will be by waste heat boiler, the second will be by tail gas, and the third will be by cold water. So according to cooling by waste heat boiler, and in this section we will decrease temperature from 900 till 300 centigrade, and waste heat used for producing steam of temperature 500 centigrade and 42 kg per centimeter square pressure. And in the next section we will cool these gases by tail gas method, and in this section process gases will cool till 250 centigrade, and in this section tail gas entered at 130 centigrade, and after receiving heat it will go till 280 centigrade. It's a third method of cooling process gases, and these process gases are nitric oxide and nitrogen dioxide. So in this section we will cool process gases with the help of cold water, and temperature of these process gases will decrease till 60 centigrade, and also reaction water which condensed to form a weak nitric acid till concentration 38%, and that reaction water you can observe in different chemical reactions. Now this weak nitric acid will enter into next section, which is absorber. So in this section nitrogen dioxide will absorb into water, but in the presence of air, and you are observing production of nitric acid in chemical reaction. In the second tower, those gases which exit from first tower after reaction entered into the second tower, where these gases again mixed with water, and we get a weak acid of concentration 6 till 10%, and that weak acid again enter into the first absorption tower. The last and next section is bleaching and storage of nitric acid, and in this section 60% concentrated nitric acid bleached with the help of air to remove nitrous compounds, and that process of removing nitrous compound is called bleaching. So after that we obtain our product, which is nitric acid. Manufacturing of nitric acid process flow diagram is available, and you can match all the detail with this diagram, and after that you will understand better. And thanks to join us. Have a nice life.